We continue on section 20.3, properties of Fourier transform. Last time we derived those properties, and now the rest will be using those properties to solve equation, basically partial differential equation using Fourier transform. So the first one is the wave equation, and we have talked about wave equation before in the partial differential equation chapter, and got some general solution, but then now we can talk about using Fourier transform to solve the same equation. The equation in 20.57 is that this is one dimensional, but the similar thing you can do for three dimensional, d squared d, y squared d, x squared equals to 1 over v squared. V is the wave speed. So d squared y dt squared. So that's the wave equation. And for this problem, this particular example, the condition, the initial condition, so we have y at x at t equals 0 given by function of y, function of x, which is f x, and then the time derivative at t equals 0, x at 0 equals 0. So this is one choice of conditions. So initial condition, it doesn't have to be that way. You can have other initial conditions or boundary condition, but for us, we are doing this now. So we can introduce a Fourier transform. So the Fourier transform is basically 20.60. So this is the Fourier transform, or your textbook using a quite non-conventional notation using alpha. This is a Fourier transform in X, usually we'll use K, the wave number, but that actually doesn't matter. So that's a function of alpha and T, and defined as 1 over square root of 2 pi, integrate function y x t e to the I over x t x from negative infinity to infinity. Okay, so that's the spatial Fourier transform, and the notation is this capital Y as a function of. Okay, so then we can just use our previous property, and we talk about we do the derivative of the Fourier transform. So basically pull out the negative I alpha, in this case, negative I alpha to any order. So for the first term on the left-hand side, basically pull out negative I alpha square. So basically gives you minus alpha square. So minus alpha square. And so the Fourier transform of the left-hand side will give you this minus alpha square y as a function of alpha and t, all right? The right-hand side, of course, you have 1 over v squared and then d squared, dt squared, which doesn't depend on x. Okay, so independent of x. So basically, when you do a Fourier transform, you're just transforming y, so you get the capital Y out. So basically, 1 over v squared, partial square, partial t square, and capital Y over t. All right. So after the Fourier transform, what you have now, instead of a partial differential equation, you have an ordinary differential equation, because you get rid of the partial derivative over x. So only have the derivative over t, although it's partial derivative, but that doesn't involve a derivative over alpha. So that basically is just a ordinary differential equation. Okay, so so that is an equation that can be solved quite in a quite straightforward manner. Okay, so the general equation, of course, it depends on just the exponential function. We choose to use exponential function this way. So y would be you can write y over t would involve just say like a 1 c sub 1 exponential function I alpha v t plus c sub 2 e to the minus I alpha v t, where c sub 1 and c sub 2 will depends only on alpha, because alpha is a parameter here, so c sub 1 and c sub 2 can depends on alpha. But that's basically it. But then now you can impose the boundary condition or the initial condition. All right, so the initial condition y x zero, so y x zero is just y x, so we substitute y x zero at t equals zero here. Okay, so which means that the Fourier transform y alpha zero is basically equals to 1/2 pi y x zero, but y x zero is, let's just write one explicitly out, alpha x dx, and y x zero is just f x, so it's 1/2 pi. Y fx. E to the I alpha x dx. And this you can define that as the Fourier transform of the little f function. So this is f as a function alpha. Okay, so that that is it. And now the function ddt of this dy dt is also zero. So basically is that if you get this derivative over here, so because the Fourier transform doesn't depend on t, so basically it's this d square, d just partial capital Y alpha t, then later on we'll evaluate t equals zero, partial t equals to just 1/2 pi, partial t, Y of x t, the I of x dx, and if you evaluate t equals zero, that equals to zero. So that's another initial condition. Now, from the form of this equation, we know that, and then the initial condition, we know that f you put in y of a 0, plug in this general form, this will give you C1 plus C2 equals to F of R alpha. Okay, now you do the same thing for the next condition. You take the derivative of this one. Each time we take a derivative, this term gives you the I alpha V coefficient in front. This one gives you minus I alpha V. So it gives you so dy, capital Y, T, dt, and T, where it is 0, this gives you I over V, C1 minus C2. Now, if where it is 0, the exponential functions are 1, so that, but that equals to 0. This implies C1 equals to C2 equals to F over 2. All right. So the function, the solution what we have there for capital Y is then just F over 2 E to the I alpha VT plus E to the minus I alpha VT. Okay. So that's the Fourier transform of the solution. And that gives you the product of Fourier transform of the boundary condition divided by 2 multiplied by this factor. Now you can use the property basically 20.48 in the one dimension manner. Okay, that's basically is shifting the x variable to x minus alpha v, mx alpha x minus vt or x plus vt. So we use 20 property 20.48, and in the one dimensional manner, which means so basically let me write F this X minus let's write it like, let's just do it exactly this one, X alpha minus VT transform will be equals to E to the I alpha VT, and Fourier transform of F. Okay. So, and so comparing this with this property, we know that if you get back to the Fourier transform, so because this is the Fourier transform of F, so the original function is F, is little y. Okay, so the little y function xt, okay, would be equals to, so basically this, now instead of F, this is y, the Fourier transform is this capital Y, but now the right hand side, this one, so this is the Fourier transform of this function multiplied by this factor. So this this function multiplied by this factor using this property basically will recover F, evaluate X minus VT, And apart from the 1/2 factor, you have f x minus vt. And then the second term basically change minus vt to plus vt, so it's a plus f x plus vt. Okay, so that would be the solution, and this is in equation 20.65. All right, and so this solution we talk about that in the PD chapter, this as a general form of this 1D wave equation, and you can check that by plug this solution back to the original equation, and you can see that it satisfied this equation. Also, it satisfied these two initial condition, because when you evaluate t equals 0, so the two add up to be just f as the function fx, and when you take the derivative, one will give you a negative sign, the other will be a positive sign, so evaluate 0, the two will cancel, so it give you 0. So that show that this is the correct solution. So although this seems trivial, because we got this solution by quite the elementary method in the PD chapter, but now using Fourier transform, you can re-derive this solution using a more systematic way. So that serves as an example of how you use Fourier transform, and the similar method can be used to solve even more complicated equation.